Hi, Internet. Welcome to the Gradtorian YouTube channel. It is Thin Lizzy Thursday, and this week, guess what we're doing? You know what? You demanded it. The people were like, we like Frankie Carroll so much, you just gotta do it 2 weeks in a row. So, last week, my friends Victor and Julia were so kind to fill in for me on Thin Lizzy Thursday. So you folks out there, you know, we don't miss a week here. We don't take off for holidays. We don't, you know, this is America. Vacation pay? What? That's not a thing. Sick time? Bah. Humbug. You know, if you're feeling tired in America and you're just like, man, I could use some time off, that just means you need to work your fourth job. You gotta pick yourself up by those bootstraps. Anyway, thank you so much, Victor and Julia, for filling in. So they did Frankie Carroll, which was randomly chosen by the random song generator. And by randomly, I mean I kept going until I actually got a Thin Lizzy song, because I got like 8 Black Star Rider songs in a row. And I feel like if I'm going to have someone fill in for me on Thin Lizzy Thursday, they should at least do Thin Lizzy or Phil Lynott, because they probably don't even know what Black Star Riders is. So, but just so you get my thoughts on the song, we're going to be doing Frank Carroll today, so you can figure out what Greg thinks about this one. Lyrically, it's a character piece, and I'm pretty certain it's about a fictitious character. There is an Irish hurler, who was named Frank Carroll, but he was born in 71, so the song is likely not about him. But actually, I'll read the lyrics before we go into the song. So, Frankie Carroll, he got drunk last night. I tried my best to help him, but he wound up in a fight. And his missy got him. She said, Frankie, it's all right. Frankie, won't do you wrong. Frankie Carroll, he beat his kids last night. I don't like you kids shouting. Shut up. I don't care who's wrong or right. And his missy got him. She said, Frankie, I'll keep the kids quiet. Frankie, what's wrong? Frankie Carroll, he fell to bed last night. And he hung his head off of the pillow, and his eyes were closed shut tight, and his missy, she got up and turned out the light. Frankie, what's wrong? Frankie was with a woman last night. So, character piece. The last line is interesting, because you're wondering, you know, what exactly that last line means. You know, is that an affair? So is he just like a complete scoundrel who just like gets drunk, beats his kid, his wife sticks up for him, and then he cheats on his wife? You know, scoundrel of a character in a very pretty piano ballad that is, I think the Beth comparisons were reductivist, but fair, because it does have some Beth vibes in that it's a shorter, like, 2-minute piano-driven piece by a 70s primarily hard rock band, so atypical for the sound, and also with the orchestration, so, and of the same era, you know, generally, like, you know, just a few years apart from Beth, maybe even the same year. What year was Nightlife, said the fake Thin Lizzy fan? Nightlife is from 74, which is, the year of the first Kiss album. So this is, not too far out from that. So, and then, Destroyer was 75 or 76. Anyway, so like 2 years apart. But anyway, enough rambling. Let's get into the song and commentary as the song plays. Ooh, let me turn this up properly. Here we go.
Frankie Carroll, he got drunk last night. Tried my best to help him, but he wound up in a fight. And his missy got up and said, Frankie, it's all right. Frankie won't do me wrong. Frankie Carroll, he beat his kids last night. I don't like you kids shouting. Shut up now, I don't care who's wrong or right. And his missy got him. She said, Frankie, I'll keep the kids quiet.
So the trick with this one is that it's, there's not necessarily any real, like, big hooks in this one. Like, the melody itself is pleasant enough, but it's mixed, like, you know, pretty low in comparison to the instruments. And so with a piano ballad like this, you'd think you'd push the vocals a bit more forward. So, you know, Ron Nevison has done some great, great production work over the years. But this is one of the, like, biggest head-scratchers in his catalog of works, where it's like, dude, what were you thinking with the production on this album? It's not that the instruments don't sound clear and crisp, but it's just, like, way too mellow in some spots where some songs could have used more energy. And then here, just, like, I just don't know what he was thinking with the vocal mix. Yeah, it doesn't really make sense to me why that decision was made. You know, so this is credited solely as a Lynott written song, no co-writers, but you definitely, you know, hear Jean-Alain Roussel, however you pronounce his name, adding a lot to this track. Just really great piano playing. And then you sort of wonder, like, how much of it is him versus how much of it is Phil in terms of the writing. But I feel like, it's, you know, when I'm comparing this to my own work, where I've worked with better keyboard players than myself, so I play keyboards, but I've worked with keyboard players, and a lot of it is direction. So it might not be, like, telling them note for note what to play. But you can get pretty close, like, hey, I want you to do, like, some arpeggios here, or I want you to do some, like, stride piano, like, Ray Charles-y stuff here. And it's pretty close to what is actually in the writer's head. So I'm guessing that Phil had a specific vibe he wanted to go for this one, with, like, more classical-sounding piano, and I think that's what he got out of this. And so it's very cool to hear these sounds from Phil, so that is a very cool direction. And yeah, let's get back to it.
Frankie Carroll, you fell to bed last night. His head hung off of the pillow, and his eyes were closed shut tight. And as busy as she got up, turned out the light.
Yeah, the Eleanor Rigby comparisons were completely fair. So this, you know, maybe it's like Phil trying to do like an Eleanor Rigby thing, but then like with, you know, a piano element. I really think like I think with a song like this, here's what I'm thinking. It's really missing. It's missing a bigger hook. It's missing that All the Lonely People that Eleanor Rigby has. It's missing that mega hook. And it's also, I think it suffers from the vocal production, just like where the vocals are in the mix. I think, you know, a more layered vocal, like, again, an Eleanor Rigby during the mega hook, would be appropriate for this piece. And so it's just, I think it's, you know, as it's weird when you say that a song with, you know, an orchestra and piano is underproduced, but in many ways, yeah, this is underproduced for the material. I think that it needed a little bit more in the writing side of things in terms of the hook, and I think that's the producer's job to tell them, like, hey, you need a stronger hook for the song, and I also think that the vocals, the way they're mixed, hurts the material. So yeah, more critical Thin Lizzy Thursday. Love the ringing out on the piano at the end, and I do really like the I like the orchestration. I think it's very pretty. I think the piano playing is excellent. I think Phil is given a good vocal that's unfortunately buried by the mix. And I do think the overall, like, narrative vignette is strong. And I think, like, as a short little character piece as part of an album, like, it's a good flavor. But unfortunately, it's on an album where so much of it is, like, mellow and weird, and so Nightlife is, like, a very strange listen. So if this was, you know, like, to give it to the Kiss comparison, like, on Destroyer, what, Beth, I think, follows, it's right before Do You Love Me, and if, what, is it after Shout It Out Loud? You know, fake Kiss fan Greg, but it's sandwiched between Rockers versus this one is the side closer after Still in Love with You, which is a very slow number. So yeah, this is the side one closer is Frankie Carroll, and then the side two opener is Showdown, which is also very mellow. It's a weird record. It is a very weird listen. And like I said, I think it is ultimately a step down from Vagabonds of the Western World. A lot of people view this like, oh, this is the first time with the classic lineup. Vagabonds is, you know, it's bullshit. I'm like the other direction. I think Vagabonds was Eric Bell showing the world that Thin Lizzy was, like, a top-tier band to be reckoned with and just a killer, killer album. And then I think this album is let down by, like, some weird production and arrangement choices. And this song, I think, it's very pretty. And I think this would work fine as is on a different album as a, like, change of pace. But the fact that the entire album, you know, for the most part, is kind of like this, in terms of, like, the mellowness, not necessarily with orchestration and piano, but, like, you know, the Rockers are, like, the odd ones out on this album, and so I think it's, you know, judging it on its own, it's a cool little character piece that gives you, like, the atmosphere for this character and does very well with that. But as a song, I think it leans more towards the forgettable side of Lizzy, if I'm being honest. I think it's enjoyable. I like it. Like, I don't listen to it and like, oh, this sucks. But it's not necessarily one I reach toward because if I want some, like, you know, pretty, like, neoclassical piano, there's other songs that do that better with better hooks. This song doesn't really provide much in the realm of hooks, and that's, I think, a problem if you're, like, a pop band, and especially if you're doing an entire album of, like, mellow stuff. You know, you better have some hooks on those mellow songs. So, yeah, this is going to be one of the lower-ranked songs for me. So let's see where we end up placing Frankie Carroll. Oh, man, so here's the trick. Charlie, I Gotta Go is catchier. Yeah, and so is The Spirit of Man, actually. And When the Night Comes In is also catchier. Oh my goodness. I don't want to rank it that low. Yeah, I, because the thing is, even though, like, this is, like, lacking hooks and lacking a lot of things I view as essential, I still think, like, it's good for what it is. And so, I don't want to put it that low. Where seems reasonable for this? Man, this is tough. This feels very mean. Yeah, you know what? Alright, so here's you know what? Yeah, alright, this is shocking even me, because I thought, oh, I'll rank it somewhere, but yeah, I guess I'm ranking it at the bottom. I really didn't see that coming, because I like classical stuff. Like, I like the piano, I like the character piece, but I think, like, yeah, this is... No, I can't. I can't. Alright, man. So, the trick is, like, Spirit of Man, as I've reflected upon it, I appreciate it more, especially when I heard, like, a different mix of it that cut out some of the instrumentation and really let the hook shine. I think it's stronger, the writing is stronger than I gave it credit for. And When the Night Comes In, like, yeah, it annoyed me at the time. And it's, like, a pretty empty, meaningless song. But it does at least have a hook. The lyrics are good. The lyrics are good. You know what? Yeah, I'm just going to have to put it here. That's just, you know, maybe I'll feel differently on a different day and I'll be like, I can't put Frankie Carroll down here. But I think this is where I'm going to put it. And I'm shocking myself with this. I did not think it would rank at the bottom. I thought like, C or B or something. But I'm looking at the list. I'm like, you know what? I'd probably rather revisit The Spirit of Man. And even, like, give When the Night Comes In another chance to see if it, like, grew on me. Maybe the trick is because I haven't listened to that one in a while, and I'm looking at it with a rose-tinted glasses like, it wasn't that bad. I remember that hook. I remember the words, because it's the words in the chorus. But that's where I'm putting it. Frankie Carroll at the bottom. Shocking even me. Let me know your thoughts on this in the comments down below. I am shocked. I am angry at Greg. How could Greg do this? Stick around for the fan vote. For the next Thin Lizzy Thursday. I don't like calling it fan vote, community vote. People who hang out with Greg on Thursdays vote. There we go. That's a more accurate descriptor. All right. And, I'm looking forward to discussing this one with you guys in the comments. I'll see you guys soon. And remember, please vote in the community tab. Bye, everyone.